In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to set up a character using Unity and the VHBuilder. The VHBuilder is a tool we include with the toolkit that lets you get an interaction set up very quickly, add questions, answers, nonverbal behavior, record dialogue, everything you need to do to have a fully functional virtual human, all in just a couple of minutes. First, though, I'm going to need a character, so I'm going to go to Art, Characters, ICT, and Resources. Go ahead and bring in a couple characters to show them off. Here's Rio. He's very useful. And then Rachel. Show a little contrast. We'll have Justin, who's not quite the same style as everyone else. Why don't we bring in Brad? We'll have him do all the heavy lifting for this. So I have a few characters dropped in. I'm going to go ahead and hit play in the scene. While that's spinning up, I'm going to go ahead to the launcher and hit advanced and then launch the VHBuilder itself. There it is. Won't need that for now. So the VHBuilder is a very straightforward tool. You're going to want to keep an eye on this text field here and the icon in the upper right. That lets you know what state it's in and generally what the next step is. For now, it's asking please create or load a scenario. Well, that's pretty straightforward. Go ahead and create a scenario. I'm going to call it tutorial. Saves these to the data folder slash VHBuilder in your toolkit install. You can see there's a list of characters here that's blank, and so VHBuilder suggesting I query or add characters. Well, I will hit query. It'll give me now a list of all the characters in whatever the open scene is. So here it's Brad and Justin, Rachel and Rio. I'm going to give Brad a line of dialogue. On the left, we have all of Brad's questions, and on the right, all of his answers. Questions are things I would say, and answers are obviously things he would say. So let's go ahead and give Brad an answer for the question, what do you do for fun? Hit enter to commit that, and then I think he'll say, I like to give tutorials. Now I have a question and an answer. I need to show a relationship between them. So go ahead and hit link, which turns green when I have a pair selected. And that codes into the system that when someone asks, well, Brad, what do you do for fun? He should say, I like to give tutorials. You can actually have many questions linked to one answer or one question linked to many answers. In this case, it's just a simple example. I need to hit apply, which is turned red here, so that it writes all these changes and Brad will know what's going on. If I want a preview line, I can just double click.
I like to give tutorials.
And Brad will answer using the text-to-speech system. I can change his voice, or I could record my own line. In this case, I think I'll do that. Just select an answer, and then I'll come down here to record and just press and hold that while I say what I want him to say. I like to give tutorials. So now you may have seen a couple windows pop up there. That was Sox doing the lip sync and some of the behaviors. You can also integrate this with face effects. That's how a lot of the lip sync for the example lines in the toolkit that we provide were done. But Sox is set up by default. Now I'm going to go over to nonverbal, this other tab, and change the way Brad animates when he says that. So as you can see, we have a rule input file, and then these are the rules. And then the posture, what that means is this is where Brad's getting his behaviors. These are each of the individual rules. So, for example, you can see if we switch. And then here's the posture that the rule is for. What we have here is a list of words that Brad, whenever he says them, and he's in this posture, he'll play a certain animation, as you can see in this list here. Above it is the list of all the animations in the system. So if I want to preview an animation, I can just double-click it. It'll play whichever animation. Now, when Brad says, for example, I like giving tutorials, he's going to go ahead and do this idle me left 01. Well, I'm not a huge fan of that animation, so I'm just going to go ahead and hit delete to get rid of it. And I'm going to give him something with a little more, I don't know, maybe something a little more expressive. That's a nice animation. And you know what? Why don't we also have him just offer and give him three different animations. So now whenever he says, I, me, my, or mine, he'll use one of these animations. Go ahead and hit apply so these changes come through. Then switch back to the verbal tab. You know what? Why don't we go ahead and show that this is all working? I'm going to switch back to Unity. I'm going to hit M to activate the microphone. What do you do for fun? I like to give tutorials. So now you can see when I ask a question, Brad gives the answer. He animates, lip sync, the whole thing. I can go ahead and continue this process. I give him more questions, more answers. I can change characters. Maybe give Rachel and Rio and Justin some dialogue. In this example, I've only shown creating one question and one answer, but to really have a fully fleshed out virtual character, you need a lot more than that. We found that the classifier works best when you have about 30 questions and 10 or so answers, because then there's really a lot of options to give the classifier a good picture of what you're talking about. One more thing to remember is to keep an eye on the upper right corner for status hints and also to make sure you're not interrupting the back-end processes. Remember also to save your project. If you don't save your scenario, obviously your work will be lost. You'll have to start over. In this case, just a quick example, I'm going to save anyway. And if you have any questions or need any help, feel free to contact us through the Google group. And good luck with your own virtual characters.